they're just, you know, they're just at, many of them are just at the, not, you know, I'm not here, you know, saying anything about their dedication, most of them aren't, and, you know, are very good teachers. But you know, with their with the type of schedule they have, they don't really have the time, but, you know, they're willing to be pioneers in, you know, in technology within the pedagogy of their course, but they don't really have the time to explore what are the, you know, to navigate the Hostos and the CUNY system as far as, you know, the support that it gives, especially to students, especially getting through their online courses. So I think especially for them, I could see this being very helpful.
There's ways we could link this access to this code, and that's what we've done. We put it in the homepage of Blackboard. We can link it in the course templates that we launch to the different courses. It's not granular, but we can control the modules that appear and then just track it for us. And this is not only useful, as we mentioned, the way the information that is provided here is not exclusively only useful for students that are going to take an online course. It's for any course that they want to take, because most of the courses use technology, use Blackboard to do their teaching. So, any other questions?
Yeah, most colleges you get federal financial aid as some requirements for attendance and completion of courses. Does that apply to the MOOCs as well, or any online courses?
For us, I know that there are different approaches to MOOCs, right? Those are just free for your own learning, and those are the MOOCs that are competency-based, or those are the ones that allow you to get credit for that. But in our case, in order for an online course to be offered, that has to be equivalent to a face-to-face course offering, so that the student that is taking the course will be able to take the same credit. So for our case, it's only if we offer an online course, it has to be the same way as the face-to-face, same credits, same.
Yeah, but I was more talking about the financial aid requirement of either completing the course or not.
Same rules. I mean, you're gonna get a grade, you're gonna get a C, or you're gonna get a D and F. That will impact negatively your financial.
It's just the same withdrawal process.
Same, exactly.
Yeah, just another question. Do you have in Spanish as well? The instructions on the sections, because I know you do a lot of stuff in Spanish. At Hostos, do you have this? Same thing.
No, for this course, and it's kind of interesting. Our reality at Hostos has changed in the last years. We had our student population is changing to have other populations. We have students that come from Africa, from Asia, so the other languages that are over there. And so we haven't seen the need to have the Spanish version of the course. But it's kind of an interesting possibility that we can.
Do the quizzes have a minimum passing grade?
Yes.
Okay.
I think, depending on the quiz, it's about 70, 75, 80, depending on the number of questions. 80%, so then they just go, they don't get the 80%, they go back, and then they continue taking the quiz.
And I know it's a more technical question, but the mark as review button that's at the end.
Mark review? That's a Blackboard.
Okay.
Yeah, it's
called adaptive release.
Okay.
It's not used as often. It's always been there in Blackboard, but it allows you to create your logic on how students will navigate the course. So you will tell the student where to go next, and then you could even hide the whole content on the course, only show the one piece that you want them to focus on. And that might work for some students. That might not work for some other students. Again, that comes again with the process of universal design and learning styles. Some students want to prepare ahead and they want to see the whole content and just go case, because he was more targeted for them to go step by step, he worked really well.
Yeah. I think in Blackboard, normally the mark review tool is meant for the student, him or herself to use. You know, just remind themselves, oh yeah, I checked out this section, I checked out this, this assignment already.
Yeah.
For them, for themselves to keep track. But it's been used for adaptive use.
Do you mind any enroll students that want to take, or do they self-enroll in the course?
They self-enroll.
Okay.
Yeah. We provided the instructions, we provided a similar video on the instructions as well, and just tell them, this is the course, search for the course, this is the enrollment code, and they enroll. And also the initial survey, we asked them what is the class that they come for. So that also allow us to kind of break down and identify what courses they come for.
Should they do it like in the first weeks of the course, or they just say it before and they have to present that information?
They have to present. So then that's the key for in this moment, we're relying on faculty to tell the students, you know, I want you to take this course, and that would be assignment number one.
Okay.
And that would be key. Yeah. Any other question? Good. Thank you very much for coming, and as we mentioned, this is something that we are happy to share. We don't have any problems with copyright secrets or anything. We believe in that the more this content is exposed, the more different points of view that come will help us improve our tools, and it might help you at the end as well. So thank you very much.
I apologize for the shade too, but I have an infection in one eye.